Hi folks, in this video we're going to be testing out the Big Mac versus the Big Stack, which is from Aldi, and one of the run-of-mill burgers from Rustlers. This is their double decker. So let's cook them up and let's see what they taste like. So first of all, what do we get in the Big Stack box? These come semi-frozen, don't they?
Yeah.
So you get your two patties, you get a slice of processed cheese, you get your special sauce, and you get the typical triple bun, which is pretty similar to a McDonald's bun, to be honest with you. So we're going to also be adding some finely chopped up onion to that, and also some lettuce, just to give it the same appearance as they actually show on the box. And if you take a look at the box compared to the McDonald's box, it is actually quite a bit bigger.
Let's compare the buns.
So we're just going to open up. This was the McDonald's we purchased today. It's a bit cold at the moment, but if we actually look at the size of the bun,
it's the same size.
It actually looks identical, Shao, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's the same size.
So the buns are identical, and I would say that the difference seems to be, can we see a patty in there? Is there a burger in there?
There we go.
The patty size of the Big Stack, as you can see, is a lot bigger, physically bigger. It's about the same thickness. A
lot paler.
A lot paler, yeah. Well, that's probably down to the meat they use. So you technically should be getting more meat for your money in this. And then looking at our third choice.
I'll just say, these in here are actually seasoned beef and chicken burgers.
Ah,
right. These are, as we all
100% know, pure beef. There you go.
That's the difference.
So you wouldn't know that just looking at the imitation. No. This is an imitation, but it is a different content in that burger. That's interesting. I didn't know that. And our third one, we just brought this along for the ride. This is a Rustlers flame grilled, what's it called?
The Mighty Double Decker.
The Mighty Double Decker. And in here, you get a bun. It looks a bit bigger, the bun, Shao. Is it a bigger size?
No.
Well, I'd say it's slightly bigger,
it's
yeah.
It's the same to me. It looks the same.
No. The burger, compared to the McDonald's burger, take the lid off the burger capture, the burger size is a whole lot bigger there, as you can see. The Big Mac is not as big as what we thought it was, is it? You only get two buns with that, and you also get the special sauce there, and you also get a slice of cheese there. We will put a bit of salad and obviously chopped onion in that as well. This one is not trying to be a McDonald's. This is just something we've picked up as a taste test comparison. What was that you're going to say?
Well, these ones, where that was chicken and beef, this one is a flame grilled beef burger. This one, that one is pure beef burger as well.
Right, okay. So this Big Stack has got a chicken in the actual burger.
Yeah.
Right, so we're just going to prepare these to make them look like that. That's as it comes, babe. Do you want to just put that one on the plate, Shao? Lift it out and put it on the plate. This is the McDonald's as it comes to you as a customer. Not quite as it seems on the box or the packet.
Well, that's one of the better ones I've had, because I've had them presented to me when they've been like bits.
Yeah, so it doesn't look exactly like they look in the advert. Let's put it that way. So we're just going to put these burgers together now, and then we'll cook them as they're intended. This one, for example, goes in for how long, Shao?
You put them in the toaster first.
Right.
And then you heat the patties for 2 minutes and let stand for 30 seconds. So that's what we should do now then.
Right. Right, we're going to put these together, folks, cook them up, and then we'll come straight back to you. Right, folks, we'll give you a close-up look of them. What we've actually done, we took the Big Mac burgers out and heated them up separately. We've heated up the Rustlers burgers and also the Big Stack burgers separately as well. And we've also toasted the buns, because if you look at a McDonald's bun, they only toast the one side, which is underneath. We've done exactly the same with these burgers. Let's have a little comparison look and see what you think they look like. Right, okay, so we start off in the middle with the McDonald's burger there. As you can see, that is a standard McDonald's burger. It looks a bit sorry for itself, to be honest with you. Coming along to its direct comparison, which is the Big Stack burger. As you can see, we've actually created it. Now, that actually looks more like a McDonald's burger, Sharon, do you not think?
Yeah.
Than a McDonald's burger, than a Big Mac.
Yeah, more like the picture.
Yeah, we have put the extra, if we open the lid up for you, we've put the extra lettuce and pickles in as well. We've actually put it in the same order as McDonald's do. So that actually looks pretty similar, Shao,
yeah,
to what it looks like on the box, doesn't it?
Bigger, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. It looks bigger than the Big Mac. So that's them two there. And our third one there was our Rustlers burger. Again, we've got a special sauce in that. We've also put the...
just missing that middle piece.
We're just missing the middle bun. Right, so let's cut them in half, Sharon. Let's just have a look in the middle of them, just to see the comparison. So this is the Rustlers burger. Just cut it straight down the middle, baby. Open that up. Right, there we go. So bringing it forward so we can see what we're looking at. So they look quite chunky, them burgers in there, don't they?
That's quite nice, actually.
Yeah, that's the Rustlers Double Decker Burger there, folks. Right, now cut the McDonalds Big Mac down the middle, baby, and let's have a little look at that. That altogether feels a lot more soggier, doesn't it, by the looks of it? So let's just open that up and let's have a look in there compared to that. Bring it forward, baby. The only thing we haven't got in the other two burgers is the pickles. Sharon doesn't like the gherkins, but that looks to be a lot more soggier than the Rustlers burger. But this one here now coming up is the Big Stack Burger from, again, Aldi. Open that up and have a little look inside. Right, and again, that looks to be a bit more substantial. The burgers seem to be holding up a lot better and a lot thicker, actually, than what we've got in our McDonald's. That seems like just a sort of wafer of burger in there. But the best looking one seems to be that one, I think. For burger size, that seems to be the best looking one. For burger presentation, I'd say the Big Stack. So now for the important bit, which is going to be the taste test. I think we better start with the original first, yeah, the McDonald's. So let's have a go at that. Mm-hmm. Yep, it's a Big Mac.
I like a Big Mac.
Although it doesn't look the best.
That's my drink. I'm going to clear my mouth, get rid of the Big Mac taste.
Although it doesn't look the best, and it definitely doesn't look like what it looks like in the advert, it tastes like a Big Mac, as we all know. So, yeah, that's all right. Right, okay then. Let's now go for the Big Stack and have a go at that one. Right, here we go.
It smells nice. I've got no problems with that whatsoever.
What I will say, the burger, you can taste the difference in the burger. The burger tastes more like chicken to me.
That's actually very nice.
It's not bad, yeah, I'm not saying that. But for an imitation burger, it doesn't give you the same meat taste as a Big Mac. Without knowing that,
I think their sauce is stronger.
Yeah, fair point. It's a substantial burger. It feels more substantial than the Big Mac. It seems to be because the burgers are thicker.
Mm.
But I can taste the difference in the burger. I can tell that's not 100% beef, but I wouldn't have known that if I would have just picked that up and bought it like that without looking at the small print on the back. And what Sharon found, I didn't actually look at that and saw that there was a large percentage of chicken in that burger. So just something to be noticed if it's not 100% pure beef. But for size, for nice texture, everything seems to be on par with the McDonald's burger. And then this one, which isn't really a comparison burger, we just put it in there.
Well, the only thing that's missing is the bread in the middle.
Yeah.
Because that come with the sauce.
Yep, fair point. Right, let's taste this one as well, baby. Straight away, the bun's drier. Bun's a lot thicker.
That looks like the same sauce.
It probably is the same sauce, yeah. They've all got their imitations. That's all right. That's a burger. I can taste that beef in that burger.
It's better than what I thought they were, because I've never had a microwave burger.
Yeah. So that, again, is, it's not a McDonald's, obviously, but I can taste more beef in this burger than that burger.
Mm.
Would you buy one of these again and eat that?
Yes, I would. And I didn't think I'd say that, because I've looked at them before loads of times and something, oh no.
Yeah.
But
the Big Mac burger?
Of course I'd buy that again.
Right. And if you was out and about, wanted to take something home, and McDonald's queue was big, would you go for one of them?
Definitely.
I think I would too. And these are, I think, a lot more
how
substantial.
How much were they? Do you know how much they were?
I didn't prepare that, did I?
I think.
Hold on, yeah.
Aldi, my friend.
Right, Aldi. The Big Stack, which is that one, was £1.49.
Definitely get that.
The Big Mac on its own was £3.69.
You've got to go that, you could get two.
Now, when you put that in the equation, That isn't good value for money. That is excellent value for money. And the Rustlers burger, which we got from Aldi as well.
Rustlers Double Decker, £1.39 as well.
£1.39. So for value, sheer value, if you're going out and you want a burger similar to a McDonald's, I probably would go for one of these, as opposed to paying that. Because don't forget, when you go in there, you very rarely buy the McDonald's burger on its own. They talk you into a meal, which means a drink and a fries.
That's six pounds.
Is £6 to £7 now, I think, something like that, isn't it? You could have two of them for that same price, at least.
Part of their cheap pop and a bag of fries, you still got...
Or a couple of these even, and be more satisfied.
You'd still be under £5 if you went in there.
Just our opinion, folks. See what you make of it. So there you go, folks. That's our opinion only. You might find it different. You might form a different opinion. We've tried to recreate them in the way that they're supposed to be created and presented you the prices and also our version of what we think they taste like. Go and do it yourself. Go and find out. See what you think. That's just our opinion. Thanks very much, folks. We'll see you in the next video. And until then, bye for now.
Bye.